Welcome to another Shaper 3D tutorial. My name is Andrew Camardella, and I'm an industrial design consultant and adjunct faculty at DePaul University in the industrial design program. We're going to start off this video by taking a look at this action camera mount that we've been working on, and we're going to adjust a few things in the model that are going to improve our 3D print quality and our fit with the stock parts that we're trying to interface with. If you haven't seen the last video, go and take a look at that one. At the end, we go over some of the details that we're going to address at the very early part of this video. Then once we're done with that, we're going to add a couple of modifications to this part. It's going to allow us to interface this with other items. For example, we'll be able to make a screw base plate that allows our bottom clip here to connect to some other device. And we're going to try to focus again on 3D printing and making sure that we're building something that is robust, that is going to last while we try to use it in action. Let's get started. If we look at the end of our history, we actually do have an error that has popped up, and we haven't really addressed error fixing that much while we've been working on this model. But this face offset is one of the things that we need to address for developing the rest of this model. And this face offset here, we see we get an arrow when we have this little exclamation mark. And so we're going to click fix. And Shaper 3D does a great job of showing us the error and where that comes from. So you can see that we have this shape that's kind of yellowed here. And this is actually referring back to some original geometry that at this point we have changed. So it's something that we didn't address earlier. And we can actually see that it's looking for that face to offset. And because it doesn't exist anymore, it doesn't know what to do. So we're going to come in here and we're just going to remove that from the selection. And if I click done, that error should go away. So if we go look at our face offset, we don't have an error anymore. One of the other things that this current face offset does is it actually pulls faces from two different bodies. So we have our body 2 and body 5 here, which are representative of our bottom part here and our top part. Those both have faces in the same face offset feature, and that's a little bit hard to work with. So we're going to go through and edit that a little bit. And I'm just going to control click and then just click on the faces that I don't want to use anymore. I actually did want to use that. And I don't want to use this face over here. And one of the difficulties here is that I can't really see the other faces. So I'm going to click done really quick. And I'm going to just hide one of the bodies. And I'm just going to focus on that face offset being part of this body here. So I'm going to bring that other body back here. Body 2, and I'm just going to click edit here, and I'm going to just see where we're getting our offsets. We see that we have a couple of features here that are using the same offset. So I'm going to just remove these faces so that I make sure that our face offset is being used on one body at a time. And that's just going to help us keep this a little bit cleaner visually, and it's going to help us look through these particular features a little bit more easily. We're going to move our breakpoint up here, and we're going to make a new face offset. So I am going to click on a surface. I'm going to change my total to offset, and I'm just going to go around and shift click the surfaces I'd like to add to my selection. I'm going to change this number to 0.3, click check, and that actually went in the wrong direction. So we're going to come back and edit this to minus 0.3. And I'm also going to add some additional faces, so I can click edit there. And I'm just going to come in here and click on these surfaces. One of the things that we need to adjust from our previous experiments 3D printing this part is that we need some additional space between this long edge here. So I'm also going to offset these surfaces here just to see where that gets us. That looks good to me. We're going to click done, and that completes that offset there. The other thing that we wanted to do was also offset, change the total distance that this was sticking out. It was a little bit too far, and we're going to just move this face in here. And again, we're going to do that by clicking on this dropdown, switching to offset, and I'm just going to make this minus 1 millimeters. I'm going to hit enter, and now we have a new offset here. The thing that I'd like to do again is add another surface. So I can come in here, click edit, And I'm just gonna spin over to the other side, click done. And now both of those features are offset properly. So the very next thing that we wanna do is really address the thickness of this tine here. And the way that we're gonna do that is very simply just by going into our original sketch, and I can drive this geometry just by changing these dimensions. So this again goes into a little bit more forethought when you're creating your sketches as to what dimensions you want to use, but this allows me to very quickly update that model. And I don't have to add additional features like face offsets. So we're going to click out of that. And the last adjustment we're going to make actually has to do with body 5. So we're going to turn that on, and we're going to turn off body 2. And we're going to take a look at our original offset. And the distance between these two tines here was too large when we printed the part. And that could be due to a couple of different things, like even print quality and speed. But we're going to take care of it using the model. And we can see that we have a little bit of offset here. And so I'm just going to edit that from the original feature that we were using. And if I go back to body 2, we're going to see that there's not any gap here. So I'm going to just go back into our new offset that we created. And I'm just going to add it here to these two faces. And this is something that we could separate out. We could do as a different feature. But that should work for us right now. And we'll be ready for more testing with the 3D printer. And with those adjustments, we're ready to add a few new features. The first thing I wanted to do here was to just work on the base plate. And considering that this gets printed vertically and the layer lines cut across the part along this direction, I would like to add a bezel that gets printed in a flat manner to help support this part when it gets mounted. If I was to put a hole through this face and I was to push a screw through it, there's a strong chance that we'd get some cracking along the layer lines. So with that, we're going to add a little bit of a feature here to help support all of that together. And we're going to do that by starting a new sketch. And I'm going to do that by selecting our bottom surface. I'm going to hide our sketch number 1. And I'm going to just really quickly start to sketch out the overall dimensions. And I'm going to draw a rectangle. And the first thing I'm going to do is center this rectangle. And you'll see that now we have the ability to snap to an origin, which is a great new feature. And I'm going to next select this outer edge here. I'm going to try to project to our surface. And what I'd like to do is make those tangent. And that's going to make sure that this is horizontal and collinear with that edge. So if we start to click and drag, we can see that we've started to constrain this box. And the next thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to offset this edge. I'm going to use that edge here to define the lip that we're going to add to this other body. So I'm going to shift and click this edge here and just say that this is going to be 3 millimeters. I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. Offset here. And I'm just going to shift and click this edge. All that 3 millimeters. And the very next thing I'm going to do is add a circle that's going to help us define where our screw holes are going to go. So I have added a 4 millimeter circle. Now we need to position that into our part. So I'm going to draw a line horizontally here. And I just want this to be a reference line. I don't actually care for it to be a sketch. So I'm going to make that a construction line. I'm going to make this line horizontal. And I'm also going to snap the center of this circle to that midpoint. So that way I can drag these around. And you can see that that line's now defining and making sure that that circle is centered in this edge here. I also want to use this to specify the overall width. We're going to make that 7 millimeters. And I'm also going to dimension this edge here. So we're going to call that 5 millimeters. So now I know exactly where that circle is, and I can adjust it if needed. I can use that to create other holes in this bezel. So our rough sketch here is complete. And the next thing I'm going to do here is just create some features on our original bezel. And so we're going to create an extrusion. And we're going to modify this. We're going to make this a union. And we can see that that did not union correctly because we didn't select a body. So we're going to come over here and we're going to select union with selected bodies. Click OK. And that's done. Now those are connected together. Now that's actually 2 millimeters. So that's good right there. The next thing we're going to do is rough out the overall bezel that we're trying to connect these two pieces together. And I'm going to select these areas. I'm going to include the circle. And I'm just going to extrude this up. I'm going to adjust the extrusion parameter. I'm going to call that a new body. And that looks great there. I'd like to make sure that that bezel is flush with the top surface here. So I'm going to just double check this here. And I'm going to select extent to object, and we can select the object here. Click OK. There we go. So now we have our two objects. So if I hide our body 4, that is the start of our bezel. Body 3 is going to be our bezel. And this part here, we really want to try to minimize the amount of material that we're using and the amount of support material that we need to use and the amount of time it takes to print. So one of the things that we can do is shorten this overall part. And that's one of the reasons why I made this overall bezel here as big as the part is long. So the really quick thing I'm going to do here is we're going to use our good old fashioned offset face. And I'm just going to move this over here. I'm going to change this to offset. And I'm just going to make this a 7 millimeter offset, just like that. And if I come over here, I'd also like to do the other side. So doing the same technique, click edit. I can select this face, click done. And now we have a shortened part. So this will take less time to print. We'll use less support material overall. And we can still print it on its end. So now we need to interface that with our new bezel. And what we can do is we can do a Boolean subtraction between the two components. So we have our bezel here and our main body. And Shaper 3D gives us a good option here. So we're going to say we're going to subtract. And we're going to look at some of these components. So we're going to say keep originals of the removed body, so that way we don't lose the clip that we created. And it's going to subtract the area here out of the bezel. So we're going to click done. Now, if I hide our body, we should have a bezel that we can print. So again, like this now is very printable and it'll print flat. So we get all the structure of the 3D printer, and that's going to help us really hold this clip together. The last thing that remains is to add the screw holes here. So I'm going to hide this body again. I'm going to turn on our last sketch, just like that. And I have the circle that I created earlier. So really, I could array this circle anywhere I want around this component. And I'm just going to do some really quick mirrors. And I'm going to first extrude this. And I can go and adjust this extrusion and say that I would like to go through all. And then finally here, I can do a mirror along a plane of my choosing. And then I can also do another mirror here and create another mirror like that. And now we have 4 holes that are going to mount nicely to another object. At this point, we need to add a little bit of relief here for the interference fit between these two components. Because right now, if we just look at the two bodies together, there's no gap. And that's not going to work. So again, we're going to select our offset surface. I'm going to create an offset there using just these vertical surfaces, just so there's a little bit of extra room. And this might be something later on that could be taken care of by a taper or something like that to really get a good fit. But for right now, we're just testing. So I'm just going to put this at 0.1. And that went in the wrong direction. So again, we're going to come back to our offset. We're just going to make that a minus 0.1, just like that. And that looks pretty good right there. So that completes our base component. Now we have a nice bezel that will hold this clip in place, and our body from before, body 2, will slide in nicely and interface with both of those components. At this point, we've adjusted this model so that we've included some of the changes that came out of our analysis in 3D printing. And we've also added this additional bezel that's going to help us mount this base plate. In the next video, we're going to take a look at how to add a finger joint to the back of the main clip so that we can add other accessories and connect it to other components. Hope to see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.